I will probably go drink something as well, so enjoy the music until everyone is in the lobby and stuff. Wait. No, wait, the warm-ups are done already, right? We have 15 minutes after. Oh, okay, wait. Alright. Shuri, by the way, I see victory screen. No problem, thanks. Alright, we are seeing the HE2 protect, the DT2 protects. I can't see who did what, but Peru banning DT1 and DT3 is banned by Singapore. And actually Singapore now picking the Nomad 1. Going straight into the Nomad 1 after we just watched it. I can't wait. I can't wait to watch him 1-1 again. But yeah, as we have seen, no 1-1, very consistency, aim heavy, 4 minutes 46 seconds, slow, 174 BPM. OD 8, so accuracy will be high. And yeah, we are seeing the rosters here now for the first time.
By the way, thanks for the raid totally. Thank you very much. I saw there was a TV going on between... Oh, looks like Hungary won the TV between Spain and Hungary. Nice.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I didn't get to commentate the number one last time, so I'll do it this time.
Alright.
So because for some reason I like the map.
I don't know which one can be fun, but this map is hella boring. This one is very boring.
Alright, prediction out. I'll put out a new stream alert. Actually, Tay, can you do it?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. I'm pretty sure there's one being streamed on the other channel too. Actually, no, I don't think there is. You guys in a second, just checking something regarding to the next match. Oh yeah, so Tay.
Yes.
A10, which is Hungary vs USA, ATDC, looks like it's going to be rescheduled to tomorrow.
Oh,
right. So we're going to be B2, which is Mexico versus Israel, will be streamed on the main channel instead. Meaning, this is the last match I have to stream. I'm almost free.
Well, I mean, Israel wants its main channel stream anyway, so
yeah.
I guess lucky for them.
They're about to win.
Yeah, yo, that's a statement. Alright, as I can see, predictions are out. So everyone do your predictions if you want to.
All right.
Singapore seed 24, Peru seed 8. I mean, this is a number 1, so really anyone can win.
I'm a believer in Singapore. I believe in Shiraishi to carry this. Actually, no, Shiro Nai is over there. Oh no.
I can tell you for sure that Twitch chat has no belief in Singapore.
You've got to believe in the lower seeds sometime. You saw how Taiwan nearly took down Brazil, and Shirashi's already broken over.
If you go by voters, they have 6 against 10, but if you go by the amounts, it's really not comparable.
Don't worry, right, I can make the No Mod 1 exciting with commentary. Also, I'll update the MP real quick.
Alright, but... Oh, my Angel James dropping the C, so... There's no FCs left for Singapore, and we have 4 away, still 4 Peru here early on. But those were only early misses, so anything can really happen.
Yeah, for a team like Peru, just completely 4-waying No Mod 1 is a realistic possibility. So when you're Singapore, you're very broken early, but you know, it's just an early break. You might be able to recover. Now you just see at the break that they're 4-waying. It's just like, what do you do?
Yeah, I mean, the accuracies on Singapore's side are better, considering Shionai has only 96%. And meanwhile, Singapore has almost 4 people on 99. Shiraishi still going there, still going up there. So yeah, the score lead is not too far off. If Peru finds a few misses here and there, then this score lead can go over really quickly.
I also just noticed how long the Snowman one is. Why is it tiebreaker length?
It's even longer than the tiebreaker.
Why? Oh, Banjo moment with Shiraishi. Oh, wait for it. Oh, never mind. Oh, what? Whoa. Oh, okay.
What?
That's Banjo.
Angel what? James? And Banjo, alright.
Oh, never mind.
Thank you, Banjo.
Right, so as it stands, exiting the first Ki, Peru sit on a 4-way FC because they're Peru, they don't care. And Singapore sits on quite a few decent combos.
Medi has some shakes here. This could lead to a miss, actually, or a slider back even, but I don't know how he's still holding.
No, as someone who partakes in the... Oh, never mind.
Oh, and there he goes, alright.
I was about to say, as someone who partakes in shaking, yeah, okay.
Oh, Shiraishi.
Yeah, that's good.
Dropping as well.
No freeway... No, damn it. No 4-way FC for Peru. I'm tired. No 4-way FC for Peru. But at this point, we've got a freeway, and I think someone's crashed.
We love Bencho.
I think someone's crashed just because of how long it's taking.
Yeah, that could be the case. I mean, if you crash now, 30 seconds rule does not apply.
Let's check the MP. Everyone's still there.
Yeah, maybe just try to panic. Does it help?
Alright, let's panic, and no, it's just not going to put me back in the game. Let's find out.
So,
we're back?
Let's see if anyone's missing. It's
okay,
no
that was
one.
Just Banjo being Banjo, okay.
Alright,
and in the meantime, it looks like Shiraishi broke at some point, but actually, no, it's just the same.
Yeah, no one has broken, there hasn't been any changes since we couldn't see. Wait, everyone's still holding? Kiro's still on the
three-way.
Yeah,
everyone's still holding, am I right, Tay?
Fubuki breaking the 1k combo, that was big for Singapore, but yeah, Peru just running away with this 200k score lead.
I might be the one to say it with Stamina's earlier breaking, it may be over.
It's Jova. Truly Jova.
Now it's just a question of whether we can get a freeway FC. I've just seen Delta's accuracy.
Oh, Kanon breaking,
yeah,
so
Kanon's
no three-way, but can we see a two-way?
Why is this accuracy from Galdor? And
yeah,
from Stamina's earlier, and from My Angel James, wow.
Yo, My Angel James as well, I believe that's only 2 or 3 100s, I would say.
Boosted players are scary.
Three. Hey, this is only OD8, but still very scary to be able to get high accuracies. But yeah, Peru gets the first breakpoint even.
Alright, Shiranai and Daldor EU with the FC, My Angel James with a very large combo right behind. And Peru will take this map 700k. most definitely not what Singapore wanted.
Yeah, oh, 2 100s and 150 from James.
Wow. Wow,
and
what can I
say? Daldor, 7 100s. Alright.
Osu players are scary.
Oh, Stan Roselia as well, 3 100s, 150, one miss. Yeah, this snowboard one just comes down to shit misses, really. It's very long. Maybe not the greatest first pick. But yeah, anyway, we are going over to Peru's pick.
There's only one team who I know who can pull off a Nomad One first pick one. It's the UK.
All right. Yeah, Peru. I can see them just go with the skill cap maps, the Nomad 3, the Nomad 5, the Hard Rock. Those are the most probable picks for higher seeds. But I believe since we have Shironai for Peru, who is a great hidden player, we could see Hidden One actually being picked. Well, yeah, we will see Peru taking the time.
And there it is.
It's Hard Rock 1, okay.
It's time for a puzzling map. I will now see myself out.
We are getting to see the banger. Let's go. Hard Rock 1, banger song. The best song in the map pool. Let's go. It is 3 minutes and 25 seconds long. 180 BPM. TS 5.2, AR10, OD10. Very basic stats. It's a very basic map.
Yeah, but although it is quite basic, there's quite a few things in this map that can catch you unaware, such as a very certain slider.
Oh, the slow slider.
That slider is such a meme, I'll never get over it.
And I believe after the slow slider comes the stream pattern as well, so you can even break on that.
I'm surprised more people haven't broken on that stream pattern. Because, like, you'd think that would be like the major choke point of the map, but like per game there's only like one or two people who break, sometimes none.
Yeah, I'm also surprised that we don't see any breaks on that stream pattern, just because it's kind of spaced, and after that slow slider, which is very long, I mean I would break on that most definitely.
Alright, looks like we're seeing a few changes. Toshi Fury, Captain DS, and Hazard coming in for Singapore and Peru respectively.
Oh, Captain DS has been so long in the six-digit scene, I believe. I know I've played a tournament against him, and that has been quite a while. Since I was six digits. But yeah, for Peru, we have seen Daldor, Kanon, Shironai, Hazard.
Oh wow, that is a starting to have a cannon.
The early stream patterns, what can we say? Most people just drop the accuracies.
Yeah, I mean,
and we've seen,
remember what I was saying earlier in another match about if you miss on Hard Rock, you can drop so much accuracy trying to recover. Just look at Kanon's accuracy and compare it to the rest of Peru.
Yeah.
Still early though. It is a decently long map. So we should see a decent amount of... Let's see. Oh, and the...
Oh, she's dropping!
Yeah, the... I don't have a name for that. Oh, Stan
Roselia. Oh, Roselia!
And
Daldo is trading one of them. But Ubuki, your arrow is just breaking apart on a Singapore side. There's only Captain BS left.
This ain't very good to say the least.
Oh, Hazard, he is shaking. He could be one to drop later
on
as well.
All Peru need to do is maintain combos on Shironai, Hazard, Kanon, and even then they can afford the loss of one. And probably even two.
Yeah. I would say the likely loss would be a Hazard just because of his shake he has. I don't even know how he's aiming this.
I don't know either, but people who shake like mad somehow hit everything.
Yeah, some of those exist. The idol keeps on breaking, but doesn't really matter, really. It's only the 3 FCs for Peru that matter. We are at the halfway point, and Singapore is recovering a little bit. Captain Bear is still holding on to the FC, but they really need to see some breaks from Peru right now.
Yeah, look at the accuracy on Shiro 9, compare it to Captain BS, so...
Stan Roselia breaks.
With another drop, really not helping Singapore's cause as the lead extends to 450,000.
There's still 3 FCs on Peru. Still halfway.
Although, there is the funny slide is coming up, as well as the funny stream. Here it is. There's one break.
Oh, Captain BS!
Okay, one two.
No, Captain BS, wait, cannot break.
And no one got caught.
Okay, no one breaks on the slide. Thank you.
Stream coming up.
Yeah, stream coming up right after this break.
Oh, wow.
Oh, three reset. And only Shiro Knight is FCing. Only Shiro Knight is FCing.
Yeah, it's only Shiro Knight. And Singapore just has no combo. There's not much they can do, really. Even if Shiro Knight breaks, the map is over. But yeah, what a performance from Shiro Knight here on the Hard Rock 1. Really feeling it, getting the carry performance as a D ranker of the team.
As a D ranker, yes.
As a D ranker, yes.
True. Very true. And... yeah, Peru is winning their own pick on HR1 with a single FC, but their team consistency is also very good. 500k score on everyone. Yes.
Yeah.
So a big very win strong. On for Peru.
Oh yeah. By the way, Rakulin, since you're back, I'll now let you take the second commentary slot. I'll remain muted, just so we don't overcrowd right. Commentary and all that.
All right. Sure. So the second point goes to Peru, solidifying their own breakpoint that they just take. And also I see Nomad 1 first pick, what?
Yeah, Singapore picked Nomad 1 first and...
wow.
But it didn't go well.
I bet Singapore is going to pick HD1.
Well, I don't know about that. I believe Peru has a very good HD1 roster.
Singapore also have a good HD players.
Yeah, I don't know the protects, but if you say it like that, I could see HD2 being protected by Singapore then. Maybe Peru with the DT2 protects. But we'll see. I don't really know. I don't think Hidden One is a good pick, but then again, there's not really much Singapore can pick. So yeah, we will see. There's not really a lot of options as the lower seed. And yeah, Singapore taking the time, showing their respect to Peru, really trying to think this out. Using all of the 2 minutes. But yeah, Peru has to win this match to go second place in their group, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, see? I told you HD1.
Alright, then we go with Hidden One.
Yes, I told you HD1.
I guess there are not enough options to pick something else.
So, yeah, the reason for Singapore to pick HD1 is either they're confident they can win HD over Peru, or they just want to exhaust all of the consistency pick in this pool.
Yeah, consistency as a lower seed is probably the way here. I mean, you can just pray for shit misses from the higher seeded team and get the points just like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, we are seeing rap coming in for Peru.
Yeah, to answer Miji question, yeah, he was 6-digit when the Rex closed. So he did decay back in time. Okay, anyways, continue. Hello, T.
Yes, hello.
Okay, I thought you were talking.
Oh, no, I have nothing to continue talking about.
So this HD1 is, it's gonna be a close map between both of them, since Peru and Singapore both have a good HD roster for this. And we wanna see my Angel James, which is Empire, coming in for Singapore again for consistency map.
Alright, we are joining Idol. Bro, I have heard this too much.
Yes.
Too much.
If you heard it too much, then I heard it a million times since I need to practice it.
Oh god. Alright then. Rosalia finding early misses. Not looking
early miss.
But it's early.
It's too early.
Everyone else still holding though.
As you said it, rep finds a miss.
Okay, on 3 air, FCs on both sides.
Make it two for Peru.
Alright, wait.
Okay, never mind. Hoshi misreads, by the way.
James and Shuanai with the high accuracies, 99.6, and Shuanai still with the SS play here. The hidden carry for Peru.
Shiro is the perma lobby for Peru already.
Yeah, he is the D ranker, as everyone likes to call it.
Yes, a traded miss for Taldo and Hoshi, but still a near 3 FC for Singapore.
No one missing on the star jump pattern. This is so close, 20k difference, really, any miss?
James,
breaking! Empire, no. The score difference goes over to Peru now.
Oh, it's gonna speed run over there, unless you're gonna see a break coming from Peru, which I'm not gonna see it from Shironai. If only Shironai misses, then it will be a very miracle for Singapore.
Medi is shaking quite a bit, but still somehow able to hold the combo. His nerfs all the way up, but
never mind.
Rep as well.
It breaks.
Advantage going forward to Singapore.
Yeah, advantage going back to Singapore with Stan Rosalia combo. I hope he holds it until the very end.
Yeah, Rosalia and Shiraishi really just against Shironai here. Shironai holding very strong for Peru. If he breaks, this goes over really quick and it's not comebackable for Peru.
Yes. Empire also building a very nice combo. If we see a break from Daldo, then
everyone can see the control.
Yeah. Really, Daldo misses now, then it's over for Peru.
Yo, are they able to go straight into the map after the break? Daldo breaks!
Daldo did break! Daldo did break!
Oh, this is now, going this is now, going over!
Shunai breaks! Okay.
It's over. There's nothing else to do. Shiraishi, Rosalia holding on. Very great from the
Shiraishi with the FC.
Yo, the FC.
Oh, Kusa dancing?
Yo, this just went from 40k advantage to Peru to 330k for Singapore advantage. 2.7 billion. God. Shiraishi with the FC
really helps Singapore to come back from losing HD1. Oh my god. As I said, the Shiranai miss it's a miracle for Singapore. It is a miracle for Singapore, and they did take their own pick, which is HD1.
Singapore is back in this match, having 1 point up now. Yeah, now it's Peru's pick, and this is the last pick before the second band phase. And yeah, Peru has a lot of options here. They could go with the hard drop 2 after winning the hard drop 1. They could go the normal 2 since they have DT2 protected. But yeah, there are quite a few options for Peru to go.
A lot of options. They can choose to go for normal 3 since they are good at consistency. Odd consistency, by the way, not just pure consistency. And what? Let's pick, maybe if they're feeling it, they can just go frame mod 1 to the tapping frame mod. And they might not go for frame mod 2 since they just lost on consistency mat or aim mat.
But Singapore taking the time,
Peru pick.
Oh yeah, sorry, Peru taking the time. Not deciding on a pick. It's Hard Rock 2, alright.
It's Hard Rock 2, never mind.
Alright then, they have won Hard Rock 1 so convincingly, they are believing in themselves in the Hard Rock 2.
I'm surprised DT3 got banned instead of HR2 for Singapore. Or maybe they can do better in HR2.
I don't know, we will see. I mean, they are able to hold some combos. And this map is probably the easier hard rock map, since it is on the slower side, and also precision for some people is close to jumps. And if your aim is great, then you can probably play this map. But yeah, Peru
on this map, Peru is favorite. And if Singapore can combo this pretty well and FCs, they gonna need to match the act coming from Peru.
Yeah, Peru will probably have the egg advantage. It really comes down to if they can hold the combos, and if Singapore can take advantage of that, hold their own combos, and just steal this hard rock too. Alright, I guess the rosters seem to be done. Yeah, Shio and I has performed quite well on the Hard Rock 1, probably trying to replicate that for the Hard Rock 2.
Basically, if your aim is very well, you can probably FC this pretty easy. And if you can read the R10.
Alright, good luck, have fun. Are dropping out. We are starting with the Hard Rock 2. Except for Shiro and I.
Oh, panic button.
Alright, everyone has joined now. So yeah, early on there's not much to say. The map is 2.5
for Buki.
Minutes long, so early inconsistencies are not too bad.
Oh my god, Roselia, everyone is great.
Shionai holding is this? Wait, hold on.
No, Shionai, it is Shionai. It's Shionai. What do you expect from him?
Okay, true. What should I expect from D rankers?
So true.
So true.
It's 140k based on egg, man.
Yeah, the accuracy
and one from Zen.
Jiraishi dropping the FC Captain BS as well. Only 4 Buki left. And he has low accuracy, so he's probably dropping soon as well. Meanwhile, Peru holding the 4-way.
the average accuracy for Singapore is 80% and Peru is 90%, so that's 10% X differential.
There goes
plus combo, and there goes Fubuki. Yes.
Yeah, Peru just showing their hard rock dominance right now. And for this moment, they have waited 2 minutes to pick. What? All right, yo, no one dropping on the slow part here, please. We've seen it all too much.
Wait, Shiro broke?
Wait. What? Is that a break? Probably.
It is a break. What? Okay. First time seeing Shiro not carrying anything for Peru.
Yo,
this is a new side.
Yo, washed? Washed? No, just kidding.
Oh my god, washed? Washed?
Washed?
Question mark, question mark.
Question mark, question mark. ONG? But yeah, Singapore has no way to come back. Score lead is 1
yeah,
million.
The score lead is basically not real.
Everyone else from Peru holding the FC. We're seeing a three-way in out right now. 3 million team score probably. So yeah, very dominant hard rock performance from Peru. They could most likely go 3-2 later on as well. After being
basically,
so dominant in the game.
Peru just dominated Singapore on HR2.
Yeah, there was really no chance. Even with accuracies, there was no chance. Alright then. We will have a second ban phase. Peru now onto banning a map. I mean, at this point, just ban 3-2. Because your aim is not great. And yeah, but first, Peru banning, sorry. Peru? I don't even know what they should ban. Just go with the consistency maps. AKA either ban Nomad 4. Or I don't even think 3-1 is a great ban. They just ban Nomad 4, really.
I'm expecting a 3-2 ban from Peru. Oh, never mind Nomad 3.
Or 3. I'm expecting 3-2 ban from Singapore, actually. Oh, they've lost all the aim maps. Truly, they don't try to risk it on the aim. Alright.
Number two. Both of these guys, okay. These guys don't like tapping maps.
Yeah, they hate tapping. What is this? I guess we will not see number 4 being picked as well. So, next pick from Singapore, I am expecting the protect. Which should be the hidden 2. Considering hope. Oh wait, hidden 1 was very close, so yeah, they shouldn't second guess themselves. They should just go with the hidden 2. But yeah, Singapore obviously trying to take the time. Thinking this through, because if they lose this pick from them, then they have to win against against Peru's pick, who would be at match point then. So it's a hard situation. Yeah, Singapore really using the 2 minutes they have, and they are calling a timeout. Okay, so my conspiracy theory is they are trying to practice hidden 2 because it is reading, and the better you are at reading it, the better your chances are on getting FC. Okay. Yep. Really looking like it, that they are going to practice hidden too. But yeah, Hidden 2 is probably the way to go. It's their Protect. They should feel comfortable picking that. Anything else really is just a coin flip. Freemode 2, they shouldn't really consider a pick because they've lost all the aim maps. Freemode 1, I mean, they dislike tapping, so it's probably a bad option as well. Nomad 4 also has quite a bit of tapping, so that's a no-go. Nomad 5, really the only other map they could consider since it's also gimmicky. And yeah, that's really it. Nomad 5, Hidden 2, DT2, they... I mean, if they pick the opponent's Protect, it's... I have no words. And yeah, me and my Peru can just pick anything, really. They just maybe shouldn't go with the Nomad 5. And Nomad 4, I wouldn't like to pick as well, because it's so coin flippy. Apart from that, they can really go anything. Even on a Hidden 2, it would be very close. I mean, they have Shironai who could probably just SS Hidden 2. But yeah, timeout should be done. I mean,
timeout should be done.
Yeah, everyone should be joining the lobbies again. And the Hidden 2 should come soon, hopefully. Really taking all the time, all the 4 minutes. At this point, I don't even know why they didn't use the ban timer as well, just to get 6 minutes. It's 30 seconds left, yeah, but it's about to be done. So the pick should come right about now. Surely it's Hidden 2. Surely. What? What?
Is Captain BS picking Peru Protect?
Wait, I mean, why did they even ban Nomad 2? Huh? Wait, I don't understand.
Is Captain BS becoming Captain Bull? I'm not gonna finish the sentence.
What? What is this pick?
Question mark.
Speechless. I don't know what to say, really.
Okay, they took time out to pick DT2, by the way.
Yeah, maybe they tried warming up that thing. Bro, look, this is a threat. They are trying to confuse Peru. And from the confusion, Peru will shit miss a lot. And Singapore easy win, reverse sweep, and that's the story. Easy strategy, easy. It's the biggest gamble, but if they win, it pays off big time. So yeah, I believe the rosters are done. We are seeing Gamilia joining for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
As well as Miguelon from Peru. So yeah, this will be quite the map, I would say. It is very short, so really misses do count a lot.
Halfway misses are the worst.
Yes.
If you miss on a... Okay, there's a pattern. There's a pattern of literally half of the map. You just single... If you're a single tapper, then you just single tap it. You just doubles like 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, and then a slider. If you miss that, your score is gonna cap at 600k.
You will be screwed.
Yes, you will be screwed.
Alright. Going into the Singapore pick, DT2.
I'm not mistaken. If I'm not mistaken, this is a Peru protect, by the way.
I believe so as well. And Singapore has banned the Nomad 2 as well. I have no idea why they picked this, but we shall see. Maybe they have got something. Kanon breaking early, Gamilia as well.
Three has been offside.
Roselia breaking as well. Already not looking too good for Singapore, but it's still kind of early. 2 FCs left for Singapore against 3 from Peru. So Singapore would like to see some misses from Peru here. Gamilia breaking though, keeps on breaking. Even though he has the accuracy, he just can't put up the combo here. Meanwhile, Kanon has recovered really well for Peru. Miguel breaking for Peru, but Shiraishi
dropped the FC.
It's only 1 FC left for Singapore against 2 from Peru. A good recovery combo from Kanon.
And this is just over unless
this is
there's
more than
two breaks. Yeah, more than over, unless two break from Peru.
Captain PS drops the FC and yeah, that's over. That's the I don't know why they took 4 minutes for this. For this mistake.
I don't know.
But yeah, Peru just casually destroying Singapore in this DT2. Chironai and Hazard just keep on FCing, alright.
And this is over for Singapore.
Yeah, Shirunai this match has played so well. Getting multiple FCs for his country here. 3.2 million score for Peru. 1 million score gap between the two countries here. And this leaves Peru now on match points. And the next pick could potentially be the last.
Yes, and if Singapore loses this match, they will down like 0-3.
I mean, just for the meme, just pick in 2.
Oh, right, they did. Oh my god. They did protect.
They did use the hidden 2. Hidden 2, probably a bit more contested than the DT2. DT2 just really made no sense. But hidden 2, I can see both teams winning this actually. This is kind of contested. Hidden one was already really close.
It's contestable for Singapore to win this pick, even though this is their protect, by the way. This is Singapore's protect. DT2 is a Peru protect and
Why did they protect that if they can't play tapping and ban Nomo 2?
Confused.exe.
I'm confused as well.
Confused.exe.
Singapore got me speechless. I can't even talk anymore. But yeah, alright, then this protect hidden 2 is Peru's protect. This is even more dangerous now.
Okay, this is more dangerous, okay. I thought Singapore got chance, but then somehow HD2 is a Peru protect. So, good luck.
Bro, Shirox, I thought you know the protects. What is this?
Oh, what? Okay. Bro,
the referee doesn't even know.
Oh my god. Also, it's currently 12, 1 a.m. for Singapore. Singaporean?
Oh,
yeah, it is 1 a.m. for Singaporean.
Oh, the Asian and American matchup. Let's go.
Oh yes.
Funny scheduling.
For your information also, Malaysia versus Mexico is 16 UTC. This time, literally 12. Same at this match. And oh my god, it's not fun.
Oh. Well,
anyways.
Sometimes it happens.
Yes, anyways, still a 4-way. Quarter of the map, still a 4-way.
Yeah, but we are about to see the Kiai section with the sliders.
Who will? The first one to be slider breaking.
Oh, okay. Happy BS Shiraishi. Gamelier, Singapore
oh
is breaking
God.
Your heart. Only Rosalia left and Rosalia breaks as well.
Okay.
Oh yeah, this
ends. Okay, 5-1. Bye bye.
5-1. Bye bye.
Okay, bye bye.
Oh God. Peru still holding the 4-way.
Oh, Peru hold the 4-way and Singapore nuke themselves.
Yeah, they got nuked.
Oh
bro.
My God.
Yeah, they will have.
I have no words.
They will have bad dreams tonight.
Oh my God.
And meanwhile, Peru just on destruction mode here, really.
Peru
the
high, is just
the high seat,
destroying
the high
HD. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh my God, Peru is just insane. Oh, Miguel? Yeah, Miguel.
Yeah.
It's dropping the whole FC, but still, really? It's a 1.2 million difference. Core difference on HD2.
This is the biggest gap in any of any map, really. 1.4 million gap, even going to 1.5. But only a 2 AFC, everyone dropping.
Yeah, 2 AFC. And this is gonna be a quick match between Peru and Singapore.
Yeah, 5-1 for Peru.
Yeah, 5-1, very quick 5-1 win for Peru. They have secured their place in RO16. Are they gonna be top in their group? Wait, let me check. What group is this? It's
oh, this was group H.
It's group H. Peru winning this. Securing their place in. Not securing, it's their second. Their second currently on their.
Philippines on the
on
third.
Philippines on the third. Since the map differential is on Peru's side.
Alright. Peru? Wait, if Peru loses to Ukraine and then to Philippines, Philippines can come back in.
Yes, but Peru need to win two points over Ukraine. 2 points over Ukraine, but Peru versus Ukraine is just top seed versus top seed. You can count Ukraine as a top seed. Just top seed versus top seed.
Yeah, that would be an insane matchup.
Mm-hmm.
Oh wait, do we have a match right after this? We have one later on. Mexico versus Israel at 18:30 UTC.
18:13 UTC, and you know what is that time for me? It's 4 AM. Oh,
time to sleep.
God. Yes. No, actually, I'm just gonna go play Osu.
Yo, alright. Well,
yo!
Good luck to the next countries on their matches. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I guess stream. Goodbye.
Alright, goodbye guys.